ஹாய் ஹலோ வணக்கம் சென்னை, உங்கள் ஸ்பேனலத்த சீஃப் ரிப்போர்ட்டர் ஃப்ரம் நமிக்கா டிவிலேருந்து பேசிக்கின்றேன். இன்றைக்கி பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, வேர்ல்ட் ஃபேமஸ் ரெனோன்ட் கார்டியாக் சர்ஜன் டாக்டர் செரியன் ஃப்ரம் ஃப்ரான்டியர் லைஃப் லைன் ஹாஸ்பிட்டல், அவர்கிட்ட நிறைய விஷயங்கள் கேட்டு தெரிஞ்சுக்கலாம் வாங்க.
டாக்டர், இமென்ஸ் ஜாய், இமென்ஸ் பிளஷர் டு சி யூ அகேன் இன் நம்பிக்கை டிவி, அண்ட் வெல்கம் டு அவர் ஷோ டாக்டர்.
தேங்க்யூ. தேங்க்யூ.
ஓகே டாக்டர், ஐ ஹாவ் அ வெரி பிக் டவுட். ஓகே, ஃபார் அ நீ ரீப்ளேஸ்மெண்ட் சர்ஜரி தே யூஸ்ட் ஸ்டெம் செல்ஸ் தெரப்பி. They say stem cell treatment. Can stem cell treatment be used for heart also, doctor?
Now, this is quite a common question. Lot of people have asked me the same question. That is mainly because there has been lot of advertisement.
Okay.
Not only in the TV.
Okay.
But in newspapers.
Okay.
Even in the airport, you can see regrow your joints.
Yeah.
That everybody reads about it. Same question, whether it could be used for the heart.
Yes, doctor.
Is another question.
Okay.
Now, first of all, it is important for people to know.
Okay.
Stem cell, there are two types. One is what we call embryonic stem cell.
Okay, doctor.
That is when the child is formed in the uterus.
Okay.
That is embryonic stage.
Okay.
The other is adult stem cell.
Okay.
That is when the child is born, what is adult stem cell. That is, it has already differentiated.
Okay.
Into whether it is eyes or teeth or heart or bones or whatever it is. Mm-hmm. So these are the two types. Now, Government of India has postulated many rules and regulations.
Oh, really?
Mm. There are certain rules and regulations necessary, and the procedures have to be followed before you grow these stem cells.
Okay, doctor.
What we call GMP facility.
Okay, doctor.
That is good manufacturing practices.
Okay, doctor.
Or GLP.
Okay, doctor.
These facilities are absolutely essential.
Okay, okay.
Before you use these stem cells.
Okay.
Now, coming back to your question, whether it could be used for the heart. Yes, it could be used for the heart.
Okay.
And what we call cardiomyocytes.
Okay.
That is the cells of the heart. That is why it is known as cardiomyocytes.
Okay.
Now, these are all autologous.
Okay.
That is from the patient himself.
Oh, okay.
It is not from somebody else.
Okay.
It is not heterogeneous.
Okay.
So, autologous.
Okay.
That is taking the patient's own marrow, bone marrow.
Okay, doctor.
And from there, stem cells are isolated.
Okay.
And then it is multiplied.
Okay.
Amplification is done, and then that is injected, whether it is into the heart or cartilage or wherever it is.
Okay, doctor.
Now, we do it in our hospital.
Okay, doctor.
And certain, as I said, certain regulations are very important to be followed.
Okay.
Regulatory bodies are there.
Okay, doctor.
ICMR also controls it.
Okay, doctor.
And then only you can do this.
Oh.
So, we have done about 133 cases so far.
Oh, super awesome, doctor. Okay.
So far.
Okay, doctor.
And we have presented it for what we call the international meeting.
Okay.
PCR.
Okay.
Which was conducted last in Paris.
Okay.
And we have presented our series.
Okay.
So this is, I think this is the only series which was presented from Asia.
Okay.
So stem cells are used for the heart.
Okay.
Now, what are the indications?
Okay, doctor.
You can't go and inject this anywhere.
Yeah.
Certain indications are there, that is mainly for the heart muscle, which has become weak.
Okay.
Mainly because of lack of blood supply.
Okay, doctor.
And there, if you use these stem cells, whether it will regrow.
Okay.
It will regenerate.
Okay.
That is a question.
Okay, doctor.
Now, for that also, investigations like MRI, You know, apart from 3D or 2D echo, etc., etc.
Okay.
Now, these are important things to be done before you attempt on this.
Oh, okay, doctor.
Then after that also, it is necessary to find out that whatever you have injected stays in the heart muscle.
Okay.
And then it grows.
Okay.
Converts itself into heart muscle fibers. Okay. And then it goes, and then it gives force, increases the force of contraction.
Okay, okay.
So far what we have seen, and all over the world, even though FDA has not approved it.
Okay.
But it has been approved in European countries.
Okay.
And even 10 days ago it has been approved in Japan. So, you know, it has been approved.
Okay.
India has not approved it, but the process is being done.
Okay.
It will get approved.
Okay.
Now, the earlier doubt of whether it could turn into malignancy.
Okay.
Whether malignant cells could develop from here.
Okay.
From this.
Okay.
That, you know, that doubt is not there.
Okay.
But the crux of the point is this. Only about 5 to 7% improvement.
Oh.
In the contraction of the heart.
Okay. The heart pumping.
Pumping.
Okay.
You can get out of this.
Okay.
Say if somebody has got a heart function, what we call ejection fraction,
okay,
say 20%,
okay,
that is very low.
Okay.
It might increase to 25 or 27,
okay,
but not more than 7% has been reported so far.
Okay.
So that much will be the improvement one might get out of this.
The stem cell treatment.
If somebody says that no, it is going to become normal, no.
No. Okay.
So far it has not been.
Okay.
This is only one side. There are many ways of applying this.
Okay.
What you call hot sheet.
Okay.
That the stem cells has been made into sheet.
Okay.
And that has been used to cover.
Okay.
The heart, engulf the heart.
Okay.
But that is all different technology. We don't have to talk about that.
Okay.
But on the whole, one should know that it will not give more than 5 to 7% improvement,
right,
in this.
Okay.
Risk is very low.
Okay.
But there are a lot of precautions to be taken.
Okay.
One of the complications is what we call arrhythmia.
Oh.
That is irregular beat and the heart might stop.
Oh, okay.
So one has to prevent that.
Okay.
So even though the procedure is simple,
okay,
consequences could be difficult.
Okay.
So one should be prepared to
mentally
treat
that. Prepared. Okay, okay.
Now when you are asking about stem cells, you know, there are embryonic, fetal, amniotic, umbilical cord, cord blood, etc. Now here in this black spot you can see that it is contracting. That is, if you see clearly, you can see that it is contracting. That is the heart cells, what we call cardiomyocytes. This is a child in 2008, we had operated with severe heart failure, and the same child in 2014, look at the way she looks, and in the background you can see she is the cricket captain today. This girl is from Bombay. 0.25 million people are living who needs heart transplant, and they are suffering with advanced heart failure. Now, this is a artificial heart which is made by the Russians, the same company which made the Sputnik shuttle. Now this also has the same thing, but you see it has got about 120 grams is the weight, so that is quite bulky. This is the Sputnik heart where we have signed an MOU with the Russian Federation, and we are trying to make it in Chennai. When it is 98.2 lakhs, we are trying to make it for 25 or 30 lakhs. So it will become cheap. If people are buying now cars worth 25 lakhs or 30 lakhs. And this is the Titan watch, the thinnest watch edge. We are trying to miniaturize this particular heart. So India will be able to make the cheapest, smallest, and make in India policy also will be the right motto for this.
Recently, even I've written in the article, I think in the Hindu newspaper, Japan has installed these stem cells in the spinal cord.
Yes.
And they have implemented it.
Yes.
But when is India going to take the serious step of implementing these stem cells into our heart?
No, you know, that is a different issue.
Okay.
That is, you know, when you have got a spinal cord transection,
oh, okay,
the spinal cord below that becomes dead.
Okay.
Say, for example, Christopher Reeves.
Okay.
You know, he was the Spider-Man.
Okay.
The other is Michael Schumacher.
Okay.
They have spent all their money, the fortune, for the sake of research on this.
Oh.
Now the Japanese say that the stem cells can regrow the spinal cord.
Okay.
That is why all this new enthusiasm.
Okay, doctor. Doctor, many people talk about heart transplant, but I'm really confused. What is the difference between a heart transplant and a mechanical heart transplant? Can you brief us about it?
See, the heart transplant, first of all, it needs legalization of brain death.
Okay.
The brain should be dead, but the heart should be pumping.
Okay.
So, this is the problem.
Okay.
That is, how many people will allow to remove the heart,
okay,
from a body where the heart is beating?
Okay.
For a layman, he is not dead.
Okay.
So, this is the controversy.
Oh.
So, it is necessary to define,
okay,
beyond doubt that this person is dead.
Okay.
For that, we have to get what we call legalization of brain death.
Okay, okay.
Now, fortunately, we in Tamil Nadu,
okay,
this is the first state to initiate this process.
Okay. No.
So, we have initiated this process in Chennai, in Madras,
okay,
in 1992.
Oh, super, doctor.
And in the east, it was initiated in Calcutta.
Okay.
West, it was initiated in Bombay.
Okay.
And North Delhi.
Okay.
And in the end,
okay,
everybody came to a conclusion that brain death legalization,
okay,
is a must.
Okay.
Thus, it was brought to the parliament,
okay,
which passed it, and
okay,
then went for Rajya Sabha.
Okay.
And in fact, we from Chennai,
okay,
had the privilege of initiating this process of brain death legalization.
Oh, super, doctor.
And then we had the opportunity to do the transplant,
okay,
after legalization
of brain death.
Okay. After that, we have done many, but this was the most important aspect.
Okay.
Number one. Number two, as you know, when you replace the heart with somebody else's heart, even though, you know, it is the same species, human species,
okay,
but still it could get rejected because you, okay, may be B positive, I may be A positive. So, there are lot of things which could happen because our blood group, same way our cells, everything rejects.
Oh, it should match.
It should match.
Okay,
so,
doctor,
good cross matching and matching.
Okay.
And still you need what we call immunosuppression.
Okay.
That is suppressing any immune reaction which might cause rejection.
Oh, okay.
So, a heart transplant means taking a heart and putting it back in the same place.
Okay.
Same blood vessels are connected.
Okay.
So, that becomes a heart transplant where, okay, two organs are joined.
Okay.
Now, coming to mechanical heart, it is totally different.
Okay.
That sick heart is completely removed.
Okay.
And in that place, you are putting a mechanical heart.
Okay, doctor.
But In fact, that is the way many people think.
Okay.
But actually what is done is we have got mechanical heart, one you call left ventricular assist device.
Okay.
And a right ventricular assist device. These are the two pumping chambers.
Yes.
So the left ventricular assist device.
Okay.
That is made by one company.
Okay.
Say Medtronic.
Okay.
That is known as LVAD.
Okay.
They had different versions.
Okay.
That is HeartMate 1.
Okay.
Then HeartMate 2.
Okay.
Then HeartMate 3 is the latest.
Okay.
It is nothing but pumping blood.
Okay.
Which has got capacity of pumping say 5.5 or 6 liters of fluid per minute.
Okay.
That is our cardiac output what we call.
Okay.
So the same way right ventricle also can have a separate pump.
Okay.
So if you have got two, both the functions of the ventricles are taken over.
Okay, okay.
That what we call biventricular assist device.
Okay, doctor.
So that is mechanical heart.
Okay.
Now how it is powered? It is powered by a battery.
Okay, doctor.
Battery is outside.
Does the battery have to be charged, doctor?
The battery will have to be charged.
Okay, doctor.
There are different types are coming.
Okay.
Now people are trying even transcutaneous through the skin itself, the battery could get charged.
Okay, okay.
You don't need to plug.
Okay, doctor.
So that is a separate group.
Okay.
Now this biventricular or left ventricular assist device. The commonly used is what I said, the HeartMate 3.
Okay.
HeartMate 3. That cost 98.2 lakhs.
Oh my God, nearly 1 crore, doctor.
1 crore.
Oh.
So, how many people can afford it?
Yeah.
Now, all these mechanical pumps has got its own problem.
Okay.
Because it blood is circulating through that.
Okay.
So, it can get clotted.
Okay.
So, for prevention of clotting, you need medicines.
Okay.
That can cause bleeding.
Okay.
Because it is a foreign body, it can cause infection.
Okay.
So there are a lot of complications associated with
it. Okay, doctor.
Then another one has come up.
Okay.
That is by Sputnik.
Okay.
You know the Sputnik shuttle.
Yes, doctor.
So the Russians have made this Sputnik heart, that is also a LVAD.
Okay.
But the problem is that is much larger than this HeartMate 3.
Okay, doctor.
HeartMate 3 weighs about 100 grams.
Okay, doctor.
100 to 120 grams. This is much more than that.
Okay.
We are in the field
of
developing our own artificial heart.
Okay, doctor.
Following the technology
what
the Sputnik people are using.
Okay, doctor.
So we have signed an MOU with them.
Okay.
But the unfortunate part is the bulk. It is too bulky.
Okay, doctor.
So you know Titan makes the thinnest watch in the world.
Okay.
Known as Edge.
Okay.
So we had discussion with them.
Okay.
And they say that they can miniaturize it.
Okay, okay.
If everything works out.
Okay.
It may be possible that we might be able to make the smallest mechanical artificial heart in Tamil Nadu.
Oh, super, doctor.
Yes, and it might cost only 30 lakhs.
Okay, doctor.
So, that is what we are looking for.
Okay, doctor.
But for all this, you need governmental support.
Okay.
There are a lot of regulatory bodies.
Okay.
Most of the things we can go through because we have got the facilities for that.
Okay, doctor.
But all the other things to go through, it is very difficult.
Okay, doctor.
The second is you need a lot of money.
Okay.
Now, for any research purpose in this country, unfortunately, there is no support.
Okay.
There is no governmental support.
Oh, okay.
You might say that you have got DST, Department of Science and Technology.
Okay.
Or TDB or DBT, they can't help.
Okay, doctor.
One. Our financial institutions,
okay,
like banks, they can't.
Okay.
because each of these phases, it has to undergo 3 phases.
Okay.
Each of these phases takes 3 years.
Oh my
that
God.
Means for you to go for clinical trial.
Okay.
If you have got something, if you, that is concept.
Okay.
You have a concept.
Okay.
You have to prove that concept.
Okay.
And to reach this ultimately,
okay,
it will take minimum 10 years.
Oh my God.
Now which institution can afford that? No institution. So research in this country is impossible.
Okay.
It is totally impossible.
Mm.
And nobody has the money to support.
Okay.
Abroad that is different.
Okay.
Philanthropic organizations are there. Government itself gives a lot of money.
Money, okay.
But here in this country,
okay,
it's impossible, it's not possible. Okay.
Doctor, my major important doubt is we have so much of facilities in India, the infrastructure in India and so many things. Many people come forward also for research and development. What do you think one thing that is lacking in India regarding the advancements of heart treatment?
Whether it is heart or any other treatment, I think probably I have mentioned it earlier.
Okay.
What is important in this country is that we need our own indigenous research
centers. Okay.
We do not have any research.
Okay.
If you do not have any research, indigenous research.
Okay.
Then if you don't have that, we cannot progress ourselves.
Okay.
Why other countries are progressing? One, they have their own research.
Okay.
Otherwise, we should be good copycats.
Okay.
Say for example, Chinese.
Mm.
They don't do any research.
Okay.
But they will get the things.
Mm.
And they will replicate.
Okay.
Is much better way. Say the, for example, you don't go for health or anything. They make a car.
Okay.
Like Rolls Royce.
Okay.
And it looks better than Rolls Royce.
Okay, doctor.
The same way.
Okay.
They can do lot of things. We can reverse engineering.
Okay.
Unfortunately, this field we can't do it.
Okay.
Because we are dealing with human life.
Okay, doctor.
You have to prove whatever you do is safe.
Okay, doctor.
That is why all these regulatory bodies.
Okay.
But unfortunately, these regulatory bodies are not very transparent.
Oh, okay.
If you apply for CPCSEA, that is, you know, the cruelty prevention towards animals, etc.
Okay, okay.
You apply and you will not hear their reply for another 1 year.
Okay, doctor.
You may not hear.
Mm.
Now, we have got public domain.
Okay.
Where you have to say if your application has not been accepted.
Okay.
They should give the reason.
Okay.
That all those things do not happen. Now, you know, it is improving. Now it is improving.
Things are changing.
Changing. Now, the second is this. Indigenous research, again, as I told you. Now, we have got Niti Aayog.
Okay.
They will tell, okay, you know, it's a planning commission.
Okay.
Okay, these are the conditions under which you should give money or you should not give money in instructions to the bank.
Okay.
But for a research project, because it takes long time, Niti Aayog says that a research project in medicine,
okay,
has got a long gestation period,
okay,
minimum 9 years.
Okay, doctor.
But are these banks or any financial institution,
mm,
is willing to give you moratorium period of 9 years? They will never. They will never. They will only try to make you non-performing asset.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Mm.
So there are
lot of restrictions. Okay, doctor.
With these restrictions, I do not know how we can progress. We will not progress. That is why I said research under the present conditions, present circumstances,
okay, doctor,
is not for this country.
Okay.
Now lot of money is being spent for Ayush.
Yeah.
Now, again, how much money is being spent for basic research in Ayush?
Okay.
Do you know what is the molecule of certain, say for example, we have got what we call Arjuna terminalis.
Okay.
That is a tree.
Okay.
The bark of the tree is very good.
Mm.
There is a lot of articles written in BMJ, British Medical Journal,
okay,
on Arjuna terminalis. They call it cardiopolycap.
Okay.
So it is a heart medicine, high antihypertensive, anti-cholesterol, antiplatelets, anti-angina, seven properties what is necessary for a heart patient.
Okay.
All can be in one capsule.
Okay.
What we call cardiopolycap.
Okay.
But let me know what is the molecule in that, we have not found out, to my knowledge.
Okay.
Because we have grown 50 Arjuna terminalis near Chennai in our medical village.
Okay.
But there is no way we can find out.
Okay.
So which means you need a phytochemistry lab.
Okay.
To set up a phytochemistry lab, you need money. Okay. Who will give you money?
Okay, doctor.
Now, if you are spending money, naturally you need a return.
Yes, definitely, doctor.
Otherwise, banks won't give you money.
They will not loan out.
Yes.
Okay.
So, like that, you know, even our own natural medicine, for okay. that, we don't have any facility to find out
okay,
how we can make it applicable. If you get a snake bite,
okay,
I know that there is a herb which okay. is known as analivegam
okay.
in Malayalam.
Okay, doctor.
It is supposed to be very good for snake bite.
Okay,
whether it is cobra, whether it is viper, whether it is crate, it seems it is good.
Okay.
But if you get a snake bite, will you go to that Vaidyan and ask him for analivegam medicine or go to the next
hospital or
small public health where they have got antivenom injection?
Okay.
Where will you go?
I'll rush to the hospital.
You will rush to the hospital because this has not been proved.
Okay.
So this is where the problem.
This is where the bridge is, right?
Yes.
Okay, doctor. Doctor, from the bottom of my heart, I really, really want to thank you because this interview, I firmly, firmly believe it was an eye-opener for all our Nambike TV viewers, doctor. Because you spoke about research, you spoke about the financial support needed for this heart treatment and many other things regarding the mechanical heart as well as a heart transplant. And you categorized it very beautifully, doctor. And thank you so much for coming into our Nambike TV, doctor.
Thank you. It has been a pleasure.
Thank you.